So this is what we've been living through, right? So for those of you who are, you know, as of 1979, it just keeps going up and up and up. And the reason that it starts in 1979 is because that's when they started monitoring the South Pole. As we go back in time, they won't have the South Pole anymore. All right, so now we can start going back. There was a guy named Dave Keeling who started these measurements at Mauna Loa in Hawaii in about 1957 or 8, and that was the International Geological. So those were his measurements, very famous for making those measurements. And then to get measurements back before we start, you know, looking at CO2 in the atmosphere, you have to go into ice cores. And so all of these symbols are up here for their various ice cores. So now we go back in time to 2,000 years ago. And so these concentrations are about 280 parts per million. That's the pre-industrial concentration. That's the concentration of CO2 that our societies, our civilizations evolved in, right? And then you go back and CO2 is now low. That'd be the glacial period, right? CO2 concentrations are low, so the Earth freezes, you know, more, you know, a lot more ice cover. Here's an interglacial, like the one we had for the last 10,000 years, a glacial, interglacial, glacial. And these are just, you know, now it's a different ice core that they would go to look at the CO2 concentrations. All right, so this is where, what we've been doing for the last 800,000 years, and that's where we're headed now. So it's, you know, it puts things in perspective for me, at least.
Dramatic.
Yeah. Oh, let's stop that. Let's back it up here.
How much CO2 goes out into space?
Well, so
CO2 goes out into space.
I don't think CO2 makes it out to space. Not
what's holding it in, gravity?
Yeah, it's just part of the atmosphere. Yeah. It's just being held in. Yes, question?
That's not so much question on the science, but question to you, for us, the community that appreciates the science and the work that's being done. We have to go back, we have to get this message or an ideology out to the rest of the community of the world that doesn't quite buy the package. Or, I mean, as a scientist, what's the one area that we can address most drastically to start making a difference? Do we talk about automobiles? Do we talk about, is it just we got to do the whole package?
I think you have to live in your daily lives. You know, yeah. I mean, you know, so many nations are going to, like France wants to get rid of all gasoline-powered cars by 2040. Those are the things that are real, right? Yeah, it starts at home. So, go electric. You know, just try to minimize your carbon footprint. And, you know, because politicians are going to swing around like this, right? They're going to swing back and forth. So, you know, the thing about politicians is, and this, you know, the denial of all of this is, in my view, you know, if you recognize the existence of the problem as a politician, then you own the problem, right? If you deny it, then someone else owns the problem. So as soon as they say it's real, then they got to do something.